Hey there guys, so just a couple of quick things before we get started. So guys, the first thing that I want to say is that I have officially opened up a second YouTube account that is going to focus only on Pokemon. So we are going to be talking about Pokemon news, we're going to be playing Pokemon games, it's overall just going to be a ton of fun. So if that is something that interests you, please go ahead and drop a subscribe over on my new channel, which is just called Lax. Secondly, guys, we will be live streaming tonight starting at 4 p.m. Eastern Standard Time over on my Twitch channel. We're going to be doing a brand new Pokemon challenge, and then we'll be streaming over here on YouTube at 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time playing Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. So I hope to see all of you guys there. And now, with all that out of the way, guys, enjoy the video. How's it going, everyone? Chris here, and welcome back to another Super Smash Bros. Ultimate DLC Theory Discussion video. In today's video, we are actually going to be taking a look at a theory that hasn't been discussed that widely lately, and that is the fact that we still have a bunch of dummy slots in World of Light, which could point towards the total number of DLC fighters that are going to be joining Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. However, guys, as always, and I cannot stress this enough, just because there are a bunch of dummy slots which could be filled by potential characters, this does not mean that we are actually going to be getting this number of fighters, so make sure you guys take this with a grain of salt and realize that I'm talking about this just for fun. If you guys would like to read while I talk, you can find a link to the original post in the description bar down below, and now with all that out of the way, I have to tell you guys where this information came from. So guys, this information was sent in to me by one of my subscribers on my Discord server, so if you guys haven't already joined up, you can find a link to my Discord as well as links to all my social media presences such as my Twitter, Twitch, and Patreon in the description bar down below as well as the pinned comment. And now guys, with all of that out of the way, this information comes from eventhubs.com, so let's go ahead and take a look at it, shall we? So guys, like I said, this information comes from eventhubs.com and it is titled, Super Smash Bros. Ultimate has 16 dummy character slots set aside for World of Light, according to Data Miner. Now guys, this information was all posted on March 24th of 2019, however, all of these dummy data slots are still in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, which is why people are theorizing about this. So it starts by saying, although Piranha Plant is Super Smash Bros. Ultimate's first post-launch character, it is actually not part of the Fighter's Pass. Along with Joker from Persona 5, we'll be getting access to 4 additional newcomers to the Super Smash Bros. Series. Before the game was released, 30 character placeholder slots were discovered through data mining. However, it seems that there are a total of 16 character slots reserved specifically for World of Light. While playing Super Smash Bros. Ultimate's Adventure Mode, the World of Light, players are allowed to use DLC characters after fulfilling specific conditions. We know this because it's possible to bring the Piranha Plant into the fight after rescuing 10 other fighters. According to Mizumi, a data miner, there are actually 16 dummy slots set aside for this purpose. One of them is indeed occupied by Piranha Plant. Assuming a scenario where each of these slots are filled someday, then it could mean that Nintendo plans on releasing additional fighter passes after the first one sees completion after the estimated time of arrival of February of 2020. In total, this would mean that Nintendo could release up to 3 Fighters Passes if each package contains 5 combatants each. This would put the roster count at 90. Of course, that's all theoretical. Remember that there's no guarantee that Nintendo has any plans to do anything with these other character slots. So now that we've gone over this entire post, let's go ahead and talk about it. So guys, the first thing that I want to go ahead and talk about is that yeah, this article is definitely dated as it did come out last March, and recently in this past Nintendo Direct, which happened a couple of weeks ago, we got the official confirmation from Sakurai that we would be getting more DLC fighters past the Fighter's Pass. Now one thing I do need to make very clear is that yes, these are just dummy slots, so that means that there is the potential to get 2 more Fighter's Passes. However, they could definitely go unused and not add in any more characters. However, guys, I definitely think that we are going to be getting another two fighters passes. Now, the first thing that I want to say is that for those of you guys who weren't already aware, Nintendo has plans to support the Nintendo Switch for 7 to 10 years, which means that they need to keep supporting their big games. Now, Super Smash Bros. As a series is extremely interesting and also very unique, because unlike Mario and Zelda, we never see a second release of a Super Smash Bros. Game on the same console. For example, on the Nintendo 64, we had Super Smash Bros., On the GameCube, we obviously had Melee, on the Wii, we had Brawl, and on the Wii U and 3DS, they each got their own individual games, and now on the Switch, we have Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. Now, unlike, once again, Mario or Zelda, which typically gets sequels or different games altogether, I mean, at this point, we already have, like, 3 Mario games on the Switch and, like, 3 Zelda games, like, Super Smash Bros. Does not ever see a second release. Now, there is definitely potential for that to change, like maybe Sakurai's working on another Switch Super Smash Bros. Game, but honestly, guys, I kind of doubt it, especially because the DLC is just making Nintendo way too much money. Now, if you guys go ahead and take a look at the math, if we do see the release of 3 Fighters Passes, and they continue to sell for $25, people who buy all 3 are going to be spending $75 just on those 3 Fighters Passes. So obviously the first one $25, second one $25, third one $25, like that is more than the base game of Super Smash Bros. Ultimate currently retails for, so yeah, Nintendo would be absolutely crazy not to continue supporting this game. And then guys, you also have to look at the fact once again that the Switch still has at least 5 years of getting supported, because this came out in 2017, so obviously they still need to support their big games. Super Smash Bros. As a franchise is always something that sells extremely well, however, on the Nintendo Switch as of the date of this recording, it has sold over 13 million copies. Now, for those of you guys who didn't know, the Switch install base is currently at about 20 million, and with the Switch Lite, there's going to be even more, and even more people buying Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, so yeah, guys. Obviously, Nintendo is going to keep supporting Super Smash Bros. Ultimate because in the end, it's just making them way too much money. Now, one of the comments that I have been getting against, like, getting more characters and more fighters passes in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate is that there's no way that Sakurai is going to be able to continue supporting this game. I mean, there's only so many characters that you can add, right? Well, guys, I definitely kind of agree and disagree with that. Right now, they are working on one character at a time. They don't have to work on, like, 2 characters or 70 characters like they did for the base roster, so it is definitely a lot more doable. Now, another comment I get a lot is the money issue. Now, obviously, when they get these big third-party characters in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, they have to pay the companies to use their likeness for the amiibo and also for, like, their character models and everything else like that, so they are losing money on that. However, guys, that's just not true. Like, with the release of Banjo-Kazooie, they saw a ton of people buying the Fighter's Pass or just buying Banjo-Kazooie as a character, so yeah, they definitely are making money on each of these characters. And also, guys, if that is a big concern for Nintendo or Sakurai, they could always just add in Nintendo characters because, to my knowledge, those are 100% free to add in, so it would make a ton of sense if they just decided to go ahead and add them in. Now, I'd love to see more Nintendo characters join the roster, and honestly, I do think that if we do get another Fighter's Pass, it's probably going to be a mix of third-party characters and first-party characters, but personally, guys, I think that there's a lot of Nintendo characters that need more representation in Smash, so hopefully they decide to go that route. However, guys, with all of that being said, how likely do I think it is that we are going to be getting at least one other Fighter's Pass in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, with the possibility of 2 more? And guys, at this point, I have to say it's all but guaranteed. I mean, if you guys, once again, take a look at the money that Nintendo and Sakurai are making off of each of these Fighter's Passes, like, it just makes way too much sense for them to keep adding in characters. Also, guys, although I do understand that the dummy slots don't necessarily mean anything, just the fact that there are a total of 16 of them in World of Light makes me think that 2 more Fighters Passes are definitely going to happen. Because if we do get 2 more Fighters Passes, that means that all of those dummy slots are going to be filled, and 16 just feels like such a strange number. However, we know that Piranha Plant wasn't included as part of the Fighters Pass, so it would make a ton of sense if we got 2 more. However, guys, with all of that being said, let me know your thoughts about whether or not we are going to be getting more Fighters Passes or just another couple characters in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. Also, guys, let me know which characters you want to see in the game, and let me know why. So thank you guys all so much for watching. Make sure to subscribe, share, and like, and I will see you guys next time. Take care.